An Oconomowoc taking precautions. 12 News' Mike Miller is live with that part of the story. New at 10. Mike?
Shelby, downtown merchants have called for an emergency meeting with the state and the contractor to talk about what happened here. But the explosion came just a few days into a seven-month-long project. So business owners are concerned about their own safety and the safety of their customers.
The big machines are silent for now, but once the investigation is over, they'll eventually dig up the main street downtown, just a few feet from a string of businesses.
I'm very uncomfortable, very, very concerned. It just petrifies me to think that that could happen, that, you know, to beautify a downtown, corners may have been cut that could cost lives.
I'm not really worried that's going to happen again. I guess there is that possibility, and if I ever smell gas, I know I'm getting out of here.
Just in case, on the advice of an insurance man, Bill Winkles took a visual inventory of his store today.
I went around today and just took pictures of everything. So I have some kind of documentation as far as what I all have here.
Down the street at Homestead Lighting, the owner says they're looking for reassurance.
Yeah, we would like to be confident as we move forward in this, you know, construction, that they're doing everything they can to keep us safe.
Oconomowoc's mayor told me tonight the investigators will do just that.
We're going to go back and we're going to re-examine and make sure that everything is safe and that they're doing the job that they're supposed to do.
But the mayor points out that no one was killed in this tragic explosion, and he says the emergency response was outstanding. He says there is nothing to worry about for the next 7 months of the project, he hopes. Live in Oconomowoc, Mike Miller, WISN 12 News. Shelby?
I know, Mike, yesterday there was question about what happened to the bell from the bell tower. No one could see it. Was it found today? Yeah.
Well, the bell tower is down now. They took that down because it wasn't safe. They're still looking for the bell. It's buried in the rubble, and they do hope to find that intact. They also hope to find one of the bricks in the bell tower held a time capsule from when the church was built back in 1913, so they hope to find that okay. Also, the pastor told me just a few hours ago they did find a piece of stained glass just about this big and still engraved on it. It's not cracked or broken. It says First Baptist Church on it. So that's going to be part of whatever they do next with the church.
Really? All right. Well, at least they can salvage some things. Thanks.